gradient tensor, strain rate tensor and rotation tensor, how to calculate translation, stretch, deformation and rotation, and the relation with the stress tensor, divergence and curl. Let's start with a vector field. With each point in space, we associate a vector, so magnitude and direction. Now, if we place something in the field, it will move along with the vectors of the field. Let's zoom in to a tiny part of the vector field. If we look at a point x and another point x plus dx, with the velocity at point x is vx and at point x plus dx is vx plus dx. What we want to know is what happens between those points. Maybe a good way to look at this is by drawing a box around it and see how this box will change in shape in the vector field. Now, the velocity at point x plus dx is the velocity at point x plus the change in the x direction and the change in the y direction. This is the derivative with respect to x times dx, with respect to y times dy, and for 3D also with respect to z times dz. A short way to write this is by writing dx times the gradient of v. Remember, the velocity is three-dimensional, with u, v and w for the directions. The gradient of v looks like this, with a partial derivative in each direction of v in every direction. You might also recognize this as the Jacobian. Now, if we take the transpose of this, then this is the velocity gradient tensor. Let's take a closer look at the entries of the matrix with some example vector fields. What's the change of the speed in the x direction when we move a tiny bit in the x direction? When we move a tiny step in the x direction, we see that there is no change of the velocity in the x direction. So the u dx is zero in this case. In this case, there is a change in the velocity in the x direction. And now the velocity is only in the y direction. So the velocity in the x direction and also the derivative is zero. And now again, when we move in the x direction, but now we look at the change in the velocity in the y direction. Here we see that the velocity is only in the x direction, so dv dx is zero. Now there is a velocity in the y direction, but it's constant when we move in the x direction. Now the y velocity is changing when we move in the x direction, so now dv dx is not zero. This entry shows when we move in the y direction, what's the change in the y direction. Here, dv dy is zero because there is no velocity in the y direction. Now it's still zero because the velocity in the y direction doesn't change. And now the field does change in the y direction, so dv dy is not zero. And the last entry for 2D, the change of the velocity in the x direction when we move over the y direction. Here the velocity in the x direction is constant, so the u dy is zero. Now the velocity in the x direction changes, so the u dy is not zero. Let's look at the case when the entire velocity gradient tensor is zero. Then the velocity at both points is the same. There's only translation. All points move in the same direction, with the same speed. Let's take a look at this with the rectangle that we created. When we put this in a vector field, where the velocity gradient is zero, then we only see translation. Both the left point and the right point are moving at the same speed in the same direction. The velocity gradient tensor can be split into a strain rate tensor and a rotation tensor. The first of the two, the strain rate tensor, looks like this. We will have a closer look at it. To get an intuitive feeling for it, we can look at how it relates to the viscous stress tensor. This relationship is called the constitutive relation. This shows that when stress is applied, that the element deforms in proportion with the viscosity mu. So, when stress is applied on an edge of the element, then it will change in form. It might stretch, or it might strain. We can understand the strain rate tensor better by looking at the dilatation part and the deformation part. First, the dilatation part. What these matrix entries do is stretching or dilating the element, or by placing it in a vector field. Now, only the x component is non-zero, whereas in this case, all dilatation components are non-zero. And in 3D, dilatation looks like this. Another way to understand this is that the dilation part of the strain rate tensor shows divergence. To learn more about divergence, watch the video by 3 blue, 1 brown. But in short, divergence is a measure for how much is flowing out of a certain area. Now, let's look at the other part of the strain rate tensor, the deformation part. These matrix entries show deformation or strain. And again, by placing our rectangle in a vector field. And for a 3D element, strain looks like this. So this is the strain rate tensor with the dilatation and the deformation part. So, to take a step back, the velocity gradient tensor can be split into a strain rate tensor that we just discussed and a rotation tensor that we will look at now. The rotation or spin tensor looks like this. What this tensor does is it rotates or spins the element. Another way to understand this is that the rotation or spin tensor shows curl. And again, for more info, see the video by 3 blue, 1 brown. But in short, curl shows how much a field rotates about a point. So, hopefully now you have a greater understanding about the velocity gradient tensor.